hello everyone. I am Kashmira Nagwekar, Senior Project Technical Assistant at IIT Bombay. I'll be presenting on heartbeat monitoring in Moodle Quiz for auto incrementing quiz time limit. Okay, my previous contributions include download essay submissions. It was a feature request. In Moodle quiz essays, there was no way through which we can download all the essay question submissions, like the way it is in assignment module, wherein we can download all the assignments in one go. Here in quiz module, for every attempt for every user, we need to go to that particular user, click on review attempt, and then only we are able to view all the essay question submissions, attachments provided for that particular essay question. So it was requested as a feature in Moodle tracker. So we gave it a shot, and now it is available in Moodle plugins directory. The next is merge PDF files. This is still under review. It is used for merging all the course PDFs. You'll get a single merge document with page numbers stamped on it. So we are currently developing a quiz access rule plugin, heartbeat monitoring for auto incrementing the quiz time limit. So in Moodle, consider a scenario where a teacher has set up a quiz with a limited time duration. The user logs in and starts the quiz. After some time, suppose he encounters a problem which results in the interruption and disconnection of that particular quiz. Interruption of the quiz. So the user loses a certain amount of time, quiz time, until and unless that particular problem is resolved. So after the user comes live again, the teacher has to create an override. There is a Moodle feature, user override, through which the teacher can allot some extra time as a compensation for the time lost during that particular quiz attempt. And that particular amount of time is added to that particular user's quiz attempt. Now here the challenge was there is no way to automatically quantify the amount of time lost, actual amount of time lost. And also the compensation for the time lost has to be given manually with the help of user overrides. So we propose a solution wherein the connections and user connections and disconnections will be monitored through heartbeats provided by WebSockets. The connections and disconnections will be recorded. The time lost will be calculated, and automatically the user rights will be set up for the users who have lost time. The technologies used are Node.js, Express, and Socket.io for heartbeat tracking, and then trigger Moodle to automatically create the user override. So Node.js is a JavaScript runtime. It is an event-driven non-blocking I/O model, which is useful for many concurrent connections. Socket.io, it has two parts: server-side library and client-side library. It is a JavaScript library. It is based on WebSocket concept. Then Express is like a minimal flexible Node.js web application framework. Like what is jQuery for JavaScript, same thing as Express for Node.js. So implementation, what is heartbeat mechanism? Heartbeat is a kind of a signal, it's a periodic signal sent between machines. Sent between machines to see if the destination is reachable. It is in the form of ping pong messages sent at regular intervals. So if the endpoint does not receive the heartbeat for some time, then the machine which should have sent the heartbeat is considered to be dead. So integration of this module will be as a quiz access rule. It will go under access rule folder of quiz module. And the workflow is like will be monitoring the health of the connections using heartbeats provided by WebSockets. Node.js HTTP server is used, and socket I/O is used with Express for providing a bidirectional communication channel between a client and a server. Then the connections and disconnections of all the sockets are recorded in a database table. Also, the time lost is calculated. Like here, the time to consider is when that particular socket went offline, when it came back online, and accordingly, the lifetime and dead time are calculated and stored in the database table itself. Then the Moodle is triggered to automatically create a user override by the amount of time left. So in future, whenever a user loses time due to network failure or any such crisis, there will be no manual intervention. Teacher need not manually create a user override. It will be taken care of automatically. So I have a small demonstration. First, the node server needs to be started. It is listening on a certain port. Then here the administrator logs in. This is the admin interface under access rules, heartbeat monitor quiz access rule. Here it displays a list of users which are currently taking the quiz and their status. Now a user takes a quiz. Here, this is the admin side. The live tables entry is recorded in live user entry is recorded in the table. Again, student side. And here, now the student goes offline. And accordingly, the status is updated at the admin side. Now the user comes online again. He continues with the attempt. So he has lost some time due to disconnection. So when he comes live again, the status update is reflected at the admin side, and the amount of time lost is the dead time. So your override is created when you click on save. So he had lost 6 minutes, which were added to his quiz time. So when the user refreshes his screen or goes to a next question, the time will get like added to that. That's it. Thank you. Any questions, sir? Yeah. Sorry?
It's very easy to do that. Moodle is totally automated.
Uh-huh.
So every time he can switch off, study the question, Google the answer, and then come back.
Yeah. That can happen.
Hello. Does it again work on the fixed IP concept?
No, nothing as such. Sorry, I can't hear.
Easy. I think this is an excellent thing you are doing. This was very much needed. Because the developers are here, please make it a priority to bring it in Moodle Core. We desperately need this. This is a recurrent problem all of us face. So wonderful you are doing this. There are a lot of other technical things which we can discuss offline.
Thank you. Thank you.